Next, we have to find the value of 99 raised to 5. So we are going to apply binomial. So since we have to apply binomial, we require two terms. So instead of 99, I can write the value 100 minus 1 raised to 5. Okay, now it is of the form a minus b the whole raised to n. Since it is raised to 5, there will be 6 terms. The first term will be 100 raised to 5 plus nc1. nc1 is 5c1 into 100 raised to, we have to decrease a power, 4 into minus 1 plus 5c2 into 100 cube. We have to decrease the power of 100 into increase the power of minus 1, which is minus 1 square plus 5c3 into, we have to again decrease the power of 100 and increase the power of minus 1 plus 5c4 into decrease the power of 100 again, which will give you 100 raised to 100 into increase the power of minus 1, which will be minus 1 raised to 4, 5c4. The next term is 5c5 and it will be the last term, isn't it? So we are not going to apply 5c4 and all. 100 here itself, the power of 100 is 1. So if I am decreasing it again, it will be 100 raised to 0. Any number raised to 0 is 1. So no need to write these two values. And the last term will be minus 1 raised to 5, b raised to n. Okay. That is equal to 100 raised to 5. 100 contains 2 zeros. So raised to 5 contains 10 zeros. 5 into 2, 10 zeros. So 1 and 10 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Since there is a negative in the middle, it will be alternate positive, negative, like that. Otherwise, you can see from here itself, there is a negative. So I am giving this negative to the beginning of the term. So minus 5c1 is 5 itself and the term is 100 raised to 4. So we have to write 1 and 8 zeros. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Plus 5c2 is 5 into 4 by 1 into 2. Why I wrote what? Plus positive, negative, positive. Otherwise minus 1 square gives you positive. 100 cube. 100 cube means 1 and 6 zeros. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Plus 5c3 is the same as 5c2 by the property. So we can write 5 into 4 by 1 into 2 into 100 square is 1 and 4 zeros. Actually negative is there, so it will be negative. Plus 5c4 is the same as 5c1, which is 5. This is positive because minus 1 raised to 4 is positive. 5 into 100 and here the last term minus 1 raised to 5 gives you negative 1. So what we get is 1 and 10 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Minus 8 zeros. 1 and 8 zeros into 5 gives you 5 and 8 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here, this get cancelled, giving you 2. 5 into 2, 10. Again a 0, isn't it? So here already 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros are there. Again from 10. If you multiply with 10, again a 0 must be there. So 1 and 7 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here 2 and 2 get, 2 and 4 get cancelled, giving you 2. Again 5 into 2 is 10. So it's negative. Already 4 zeros are there. Into 1 more 0. So 1 and 5 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Plus this value is 5 into 100 is 500 minus 1. Okay, so we can add the positive terms. This term and 500 and all the negative terms together we have to add and just subtract. Okay, so we are getting, if we add these three positive terms, we are getting 100 100 00 500 00 minus, when we add these two values and negative 1, all the three values are negative. So if I'm adding these together, I am getting 500 100 00 1. And if I subtract these two values, I am getting the value 950 99 00 499. Just a simple calculation. Only the number is so big, the calculation, the subtraction is very easy, and you are getting the answer for 99 raised to 5 as 950 99 00 499.